In today's video, you're going to learn how to make a duotone poster completely and entirely in Adobe Illustrator. It's pretty simple, yet the outcome is really, really, really effective. So do stay tuned and learn how to make duotone in Illustrator. So another awesome resource for learning essential skills as a graphic designer is Skillshare. Now, Skillshare is a community of creators that holds over 25,000 classes on design, business, and other useful topics. And regarding graphic design, Skillshare boasts a wide selection of courses by professionals in their respective fields. You can learn more about Skillshare and how to get 2 months totally for free later in today's video. So you first need to have an image, and you want to have a high resolution image if possible. And one great resource is called unsplash.com, where you can download some really, really high resolution imagery, and they've got a wide selection for you to choose from. So once you actually upload the image into Adobe Illustrator, resize it down to fit around the canvas as much as possible. It doesn't need to fit perfectly because we're going to be using clipping mask later. The next stage is to select a color that is going to represent the main basis of your poster design and the duotone effect. I'm going for a really kind of bright pinky red for my design, but you obviously can choose anything that suits your mood or your artwork. Press M for the rectangle tool and make a square off to the side because we can sample this color later for the typography. Then cover your canvas really neatly with a rectangle using the rectangle tool. We then need to re-edit the colors of the image itself to grayscale, and that's easily done here under the edit color settings. Now you want to make sure the image is in front of all layers. And then we need to open up the transparency window because that's how the duotone effect is going to be created. Now these options here are entirely up to you, but from personal experience and from my personal taste, I prefer the lighten or the screen options. But as you can scroll through them and have a look and test out what actually works for your style and also for your image. So once you've selected the transparency effect that you want to use, it's now time to make a clipping mask. So press P for the pen tool and hold down shift so we can actually move the pen tool path at a 45 degree angle going upwards like this. Whilst I make this pen tool path, I'm holding down shift the entire time to have 45 degree and straight lines to make the shape for my clipping mask. Notice how I'm sticking completely to the edge of the canvas. That is quite important, and it's going to give me a nice clean outcome for my poster design. So once you're ready, press V for the selection tool, and then select everything on your artboard, and come down and make a clipping mask like so. I drew inspiration from Quim Marin, who designed a few posters in this style, and I thought it would be a great idea to show you guys how to do it in Adobe Illustrator. But it's now time to resize and position your actual main focal point of the poster. And I again held down shift so I could move my object at a 45 degree angle from the corner perfectly. Holding down shift is really, really useful in this situation. And if you've got the actual corner at a 90 degree angle, it's going to look perfect just set off from the edge of the poster. Now it's time to add the typography, and I've gone for a font that I have a really huge fondness for, and that is Aileron, which I've been using for a long time for poster designs. And it's going to help here to press Command or Control R to open up the guides so you can put rulers along the edge of your object. Now I've used contrast in size for the text, and I've also used contrast in the weight and also in capitals and lowercase. But yeah, just try to build up a really neat and a really kind of minimal composition for your poster design, and it will look good with some decent typography introduced onto your design. It is really important to get the typography right because it can destroy or it can make a great design. So don't be afraid to spend, you know, a lot of time on the typography side of things on your Duotone poster design. To add some balance, I've just placed Satori graphics down in the bottom right corner compared to the top left corner, where most of the text content actually is. So like I mentioned, today I'm offering you the chance of receiving 2 months access to Skillshare totally for free if you do use my link down in the description box below. Even without this offer of 2 free months, Skillshare only costs $10 per month, which really does open the door to a wide range of useful lessons and courses, all delivered in a professional and a neat manner by successful people in their relative fields. So do be sure to check out Skillshare linked down below and start learning some new skills and some new techniques today. So yeah, thanks for stopping by at Satori Graphics today. But yeah, of course, make sure you have a great day, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.